I thank the gentleman. I thank Mr. Chairman. Ms. Hincapie, among many limitations in life is my inability to glean other people's motives or be able to read their minds. I could have sworn in response to a question you received from Mr. Cohen, you suggested race was the basis for why we may have this constitutional perspective. Did I understand you correctly?
I believe I was responding to the question about is there an explanation about why.
Well, let me offer another explanation to you, okay? Not a single Republican who is here right now ever served under a Republican president. Not one. So I hope I do live long enough to hold a Republican president to the exact same standard that I'm holding this one. But for you to run to race as the explanation for why we hold the position that we do, Harry Reid had a very different perspective on recess appointments when there was a Texan in the White House, and none of us accused him of geographic discrimination. In fact, hell, for that matter, Senator Obama had a different perspective on executive overreach than President Obama, and nobody runs to race as an explanation for that. So I would just caution you to be careful when you try to import motives to people. With that, what are the limits of prosecutorial discretion?
So among the limits of prosecutorial discretion is that the president must comply with existing statutes such as the appropriations. So the president can't simply stop deporting everybody. And in fact, what they've done here is they've listed new priorities. So
he can't stop deporting everybody. Well, I mean, what are the limits? So as long as he deports one person, then that's a proper exercise of prosecutorial discretion?
No, under the current appropriations, the
I'm not talking about appropriations. I'm talking about the constitutional doctrine of prosecutorial discretion, which if you marry up with the pardon clause, means no law, you don't have to enforce it, and if they do break it, you can pardon them for it.
Right, so under the constitutional doctrine, we should take two pieces. One is you've got the take care clause, which says that the president must take care to enforce the laws.
Mr. Hincapie, your answer is much more complex than my question. What are the limits of the doctrine of prosecutorial discretion?
The limits are that the president must enforce the laws based on statute. So one is...
I thought he just announced he wasn't going to do that, that he was carving out categories and exceptions.
In addition...
And not on a case-by-case basis, too, for entire categories.
No, he is not stopping. He's not saying that he is not going to enforce the law whatsoever vis-a-vis those individuals. He is saying he is creating a program by which individuals can come forward if they meet certain criteria, and they will be held accountable to apply, pay a fee, pass a criminal background check.
But that's not the current law, right?
That is what is possible under deferred action, and that is what he has developed. Correct.
Well, I want to talk to you for a second about that background check, and I want to get into the policy a little bit. Can you tell me what serious criminal is? Because when I look at the White House talking points, they're interested in serious criminals. So tell me what a non-serious criminal is.
It could include somebody, for example, who has been detained for shoplifting. Let's say a 22-year-old who takes lipstick, and that's a misdemeanor, and she.
So just misdemeanors. A non-serious criminal refers to misdemeanor convictions.
Right, and in fact, there are certain misdemeanors that are considered serious criminals under the recent memos from the Department of Homeland Security as well.
How about domestic violence? How many domestic violence convictions can you have and still remain?
I believe domestic violence is considered a serious crime under the new...
It wasn't under the comprehensive Senate immigration bill, which I have heard lots and lots of my colleagues embrace. I think you could have up to 3 domestic violence convictions and still remain on a path to something under the Senate version. How about recidivist DUI?
I believe DUI completely disqualifies you as well.
A single DUI conviction...
Conviction, correct.
...is considered a serious criminal,
even
though it's a misdemeanor.
That is my understanding, yes.
Well, where could I go to find out whether or not that understanding is correct or not? It wasn't on the White House talking points. They talked about gang members, but I'm not aware of a federal crime for being a member of a gang. Is there one? I know it's a sentencing enhancement. Is there a crime for being a member of a gang?
Well, in fact, that is some of the concerns that some advocates have, that if it's simply if you are being considered a gang member because you live in a certain zip code and you're being associated, or is it really based
on... Well, I understand that your concern is that it might catch too many people. My concern is the opposite, that it won't catch the right people. So it's not a crime to be a member of a gang. You have to commit another underlying offense, and then it's a sentence enhancement. So how are you going to determine who the gang members are?
Well, there are gang databases that exist. We assume, again...
So if you're in a gang database, will you be deported?
We don't have enough information from the administration yet, right? Remember, this was just announced.
Well, I've got the talking points that gang members are going to be deported.
But the talking points are not sufficient. They will be issuing guidelines with respect to how they will...
Who is they?
Program. The administration, the White House, and the Department of Homeland Security.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.